classroom, that's when that home school-based connection becomes so important. Tom, what about, under what conditions might unacceptable behavior be, not be an indication of behavior disorders? Because we have a lot of kids, the Advocates from Children, Advocates for Children's report was astonishing to me, the large number of African-American and Latino males who find themselves in these types of classroom settings.
Yeah. I think, as Marilyn had pointed out before, just like beauty, good or bad behavior is in the eye of the beholder. And right now in our school systems, 93% of the beholders are from the European American middle class culture. By the year 2000, it'll be 95%. While at the turn of the century, half of our school age population will be from a culturally different household. And so we all tend to be ethnocentric. We really, truly only understand our own group. And most of us wouldn't recognize a cultural difference if it booted us in the butt. And so, you know, how do we decide if a kid from a different culture has a behavior problem or not? Well, maybe we have to get a representative from that culture to come and observe that kid and say, no, that is out of bounds for my cultural group, or no, in some households we do promote that behavior. We might want to do some behavioral recording, but compare them against kids from their own culture so that we have a better a base to compare them to. Mm-hmm. I'm also concerned that Dorothy was mentioning in Blake's case, the parent was the first to see the problem. Mm-hmm. I think oftentimes teachers create the very behavior problems they complain about. We send our teachers out into the field with no training in reality-based behavior management, and then they pick up on what the burned out, more experienced teachers tell them, which is don't smile till Christmas or Kwanzaa or Hanukkah. Keep the kids under your thumb. You got to go off on them and yell at them really early and let them know who's boss. Or if they do get training, oftentimes we train our teachers in the curriculum of control, how to keep these kids under your thumb. And we're trying to promote respectful behavior through disrespectful means. We're taking a kid's dignity away from them. Rather than trying to entice them into behaving, first of all, then use our clout if that doesn't work, too often we react initially with negative consequences. A kid feels the need to defend his honor. We get that rebellion, and we say, oh, that rude kid or that violent kid. When we've created it ourselves, we've escalated a conflict cycle. So it is difficult to determine whether a kid has a behavior disorder or not.
And that kind of leads me, I'm going to skip around with some of my questions, because that leads me into some of the great, often quoted work that you've done in the area of peer tutoring. Because the first study I remember